Namaskar friends, today I feel elated and proud to be here, explain to you what the One Mind is all about. It's about the four generations of a story that we have achieved so far, the organization that has been built and the challenges that we have faced. One Mind is basically a rich garland which has following attributes in it. The entrepreneurial skills were inherent and also they were taught to us as I speak, basically starting from my great-grandfather to me, the four generations that we have lived through. We have dreams. We have dreams and we pursue them passionately with open mind, with pragmatic implementation, with multidisciplinary approach and will achieve and win attitude. These are very crucial to be an entrepreneur and as I say, to look at the light at the end of the tunnel, basically go on and on and on. We maintain consistency in quality right from the first generation. That has been the mindset from first generation passing on the baton so far. We adhere to the values and ethics, honesty and integrity, coexistence, customers' trust and relationship are very, very crucial and integral part of our company. The unified family bondage with inculcated sense of sacrifice is another crucial element which we are happy to have up to the fourth generation. The examples I can give of that is my great-grandmother was away in India as my great-grandfather pursued his goal of business in South Africa. Eldest son of second generation was in Calcutta doing job to support the entire family. The youngest son of second generation opted to serve his consumers, his customers, instead of going to the wedding of his brother. We always feel that, and we always have one unwritten rule in our family, that family is made for each other in the sense we always have a backup system. In anybody's need, we always do hand-holding. We are thankful to our mothers, wives, sisters, and children who have shown a lot of patience, who have showered a lot of love and respect on us as we were busy establishing and flourishing the business. And they have been very calm and patient as we have eaten up also into their family time. We as four generations of entrepreneur, we have been successful so far in the sense that a banyan tree, which is a national tree of India, like that my great-grandfather put in a seed, which now has grown up to Vatavriksha with his branches moving down and sub-branches with holding us as a huge tree, making our family big and responsible. We have the human approach to the customers, suppliers, and all stakeholders. Basically, there are three or four stories which I want to tell you to elaborate the point. One of our distributors died, and because of which his family had no wherewithal, he didn't have the support. His brother wanted to take over the dealership. We requested him that instead of taking the dealership, why don't you support the family of the bereaved? It was not working out, hence then we had our own other distributor of a neighboring vicinity who hand-holded the family, and today the family is doing up and fine. We, in our organization, have three generations of employees working with us as we stand by them through the thick and thin. We put ourselves in place of the customers when we think about any policies of pricing or marketing or selling, and we want to understand for ourselves that what if I was a customer, what if we were the customer, how would we feel about the same thing. So my great-grandfather, he was a founder of our organization as I speak. He was studying with Mahatma Gandhi in his primary education in Rajkot. A well-wisher told him that in India the currency is of silver. And in South Africa, the currency is of gold. So this immediately triggered a bell into him, and he set off with a hundi of 500 rupees and went on to set a business in South Africa. While doing so, he established first a small grocery shop and then went on successfully to buy a couple of tea estates in the year 1892. Basically, then after being successful, then he called my great-grandmother from India. Later on, it so happened that they used to help a lot of Indians and the locals in South Africa. Because of this, the Britishers viewed him as a culprit of non-supporting to them, and there, coupled with the racial discrimination, that marked his return back to India in 1915. He sold both the estates and gave the proceeds to the needy and poor over there. He came to India empty-handed, but accompanied with him were his dreams of growing successful business. He always had this dream that, you know, we should have business which goes on for generations and generations. And because we were there in South Africa for 35 plus years, who would know us over here? Therefore, he took certificate of Sri Mahatma Gandhiji that he was for a number of years a successful tea planter. This is a certificate of our founder. So basically, then returning to India, he got the first job to develop a tea estate, and that was at Avkali village, which is near Mahabaleshwar in Maharashtra. That helped him give support to the family. The eldest son was also sent to Calcutta. He did a job and gave support to the family. My great-grandfather founded a partnership firm in 1919, started in a very small way in a rented outlet for tea. So this is a very interesting story which I would want to share about our brand name. He was once upon a time just walking on the banks of River Sabarmati, where he met a saint, and basically his face was very groomed, and basically he was very worried that, you know, so the sage asked him that, you know, what are you worrying all about? And he immediately said, you know, the brand name is not getting the brand name right, and basically he would want a brand name which showed the coexistence, which showed customer relationship and honesty, integrity. So immediately the sage came up with a brand name which had the principles of coexistence, relationship, trust. The brand name was has become such a famous one today that it does not require a comment. A mention. So basically, then it was said that Wagh, a very carnivorous animal, forgot his hunger and greed for the food when he had a good cup of tea, and goat, which is a Bakri, which is a very herbivorous animal, forgot the fear and had a good cup of tea from the same cup. So basically, showing the Gandhian principles of coexistence and relationship and trust between rich and poor, strong and weak. So starting from the first generation itself, my great-grandfather had this Gandhian outlook that a customer is a very important visitor on our premise. He is not dependent on us. We are dependent on him. He is not an interruption in our business. He is the purpose of it. He is not an outsider to our business. He is part of it. We are not doing him a favor by serving him. He is doing us a favor by giving us an opportunity to do so. Thank you. The eldest brother of the second generation was requested to come back to Ahmedabad, and that's how they had a clear focus and expanded the business from one retail outlet to seven retail outlets. The youngest son at that point in time had love for India so much that he used to go for Quit India and non-cooperative movement towards the British. Is that the youngest son chose serving his customers than to attending his brother's wedding. So he stayed back and did not go and did not attend his brother's wedding. This generation, the second generation, was innovative in thinking, but they were much ahead of time. The concept of packaged tea was coined by this generation, but did not see the light at the end of the day due to technical and other administrative reasons. When the third generation came into the business, they did not leave the second generation's dream of having packaged tea and expanding the business. They tried to convince the second generation, but it took 20 years for them to convince them to come into the packaged tea business. This is so, you know, because the parents always have this feeling that whatever difficulties we have faced, our children should not face. So, in the same breath, therefore, they said that, you know, wait, it's not the right time, it's not the right time. But then they were convinced them, and then they went into the packet business. And a company was formed for this approach in 1980. There was no looking back, and then slowly and gradually, city by city, in the state of Gujarat, they established the distribution network. They went on into the neighboring states of Gujarat in the order of Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and Maharashtra. And in the early 90s, they started export to USA because the non-resident Gujaratis, they had to service the non-resident Gujaratis because it was their famous kappa. So when my cousin and myself came into the business in the mid-90s, we had several challenges in front of us. To name a few, the issue was that there were a lot of marks at every area, every nook and corner, and the issue was also of getting quality tea to the consumer. Because now was the time when because of the climate change, we were seeing a lot of difficulties of getting quality tea. When it should not rain, it used to rain. When you have breeze and sunlight, it rained. So because of which the quality of tea was not, we were not able to fetch that. So our motto cannot be changed for quality. Hence, we never compromised on quality, and we went on to establish and get and convince our suppliers to get quality tea for us. Taking an inspiration from generation third, we went on to expand to various states of India, and now we are into 17 states of India as we speak. Thank you. Quality being the motto, I always felt that tea is part of the food chain. And being food, we always wanted it to have the quality accreditation, in the sense that there should be quality in the chemical analysis also, not only in the taste. So therefore, we went on to establish laboratory in those days, and not only that, we got NABL accreditation done. This is something which generally a world-class company does. We are the only packet tea company which has got an NABL accredited lab attached to it. In those days, we established an e-commerce business to consumers, as they call it, in the year 2002. With a website which directly consumer can connect with us and order any kind of products. It could be a small size, it could be a big size, whatever the quantity is, that's not an issue, and it was delivered across the world. We had challenges of expanding into various categories, and hence we came up with newer and newer products like iced teas and organic teas and green teas and various flavors and what have you, amongst and also the gourmet teas amongst the various things that we have. It was our fourth generation's idea to have tea lounges and kiosks. As I speak, we have 100 numbers, large and small, in various categories, and we are going ahead with that. This is basically to service the upwardly mobile Indians who prefer their kappa on their move. Because of all the above, because of all the initiatives that we took, my third generation, second generation, first generation, we were bestowed on various kind of awards. First being the Gujarat Ratna Award in the year 2015-16, Times Food Award in the year 2016 for the Best Tea Lounge category. The most important one was Family Business Legacy Award, which was presented to us in 2017 May with the august hands of Honorable President of India in presence of Honorable Prime Minister of India. Thank you. The last one we received was a packaging award by the Packaging Institute in 2017. I would like to conclude by saying that, by quoting Mahatma Gandhiji, that happiness is when you think what you say and what you do are in harmony. This can happen only when one is contented. Yes, I have cultivated my mind and culture of counting my blessings against the general feeling that contentment is the culprit that yields stagnation, which means one should always be optimistic in life. I believe that contentment gives birth to creativity, and it is the creativity that leads to progress of both the company as a company and mine as an individual. So, from this one mind journey of the four generations, the message to the young entrepreneurs, not everything goes according to what we have envisioned in our life. The founder had to leave South Africa. The packaging tea business didn't work out for the second generations. Need to go with the flow. Flexibility is very, very crucial and important in entrepreneurial spirit. And when the goal is very clear, you have to take your family ahead. You have to take the family traditions forward. So founder came back to India and he had to take up job along with the second generation. In evolve new strategies in response to those of your opponents or create new opportunities. This is very crucial and important. If the new strategies that you are wanting to evolve is not working in front of the opponent's strategy, then you have to create new opportunities for yourself. Our each generation has created new categories and brands to face competition. We initiated the tea launch concept in India because we wanted the image of tea to grow up in front of other beverages that are there. We encourage the practice of entrepreneurship within the organization as corporate management style by empowering professionals to take risk. This is very crucial. An entrepreneur could be one, his family could be two, two or three or four. But when your business is growing, you need to have professionals be entrepreneurs, which means you have to give them encouragement to take risk and take decisions and add value to your business. So, last but not the least, is I would reckon that we should always keep on moving in the direction until and unless we achieve our goals. Thank you very much.